and a lot of them were built on top of each other and interspersed with them, made of wood, just like all the factories were these various tenement houses, you know. And once the fire started, it was over, really, you know, and it got off to a running start. The firemen responded, as they always did, as quickly as possible, but once they got down there, it didn't take long to figure out at least the battle for Boston Street was lost. You know, one of the problems is they set up the first hydrant and it was too hot to stand there and use it, so they moved up to the next one up the street and it didn't work. You know, every fireman's nightmare, and finally they got hooked into hydrants that did work. The fire is racing up the street here and it's starting to spread down Federal, Fowler, and getting up towards Essex Street, you know, and that whole residential neighborhood is really threatened or whatever. So, and one of the really nightmare things was the original report filed in the Salem News at 2:25 to go to print for the evening edition. They mentioned that all of Boston Street was either involved or going to be involved, and then chillingly they mentioned about five paragraphs down, it is believed that 20 young women are trapped in the leather factories that are burning. It's just too hot to go in and check. They also mentioned that Charles Lee, who jumped out the third floor, heavily burned and broke legs, was not expected to survive. Mercifully, both of those were false. It turned out like only three people died directly in the fire. A few others died as a result of the fire complications, and a few were reported missing. But at any rate, the fire worked its way up here, and thank God the firemen, with a little help of Mother Nature, got the fire to shift down Highland Avenue briefly before letting it continue east. And that spared what we now call the McIntyre District. You know, you think of an area without Federal or Essex or Chestnut or Warren Streets, could have been all gone, you know. So mercifully they got a stop there, as they use in the firefighter parlance. It started heading east again, essentially between Broad and Jackson Street, more or less. And the fire burned down that way almost utterly unimpeded.
The Department of Defense at the federal government was actually the proprietor of the funding to Salem. And there were a number of really, you know, amazing pieces of literature of thanks from our community, and particularly from the mayor, to the federal officials who provided aid to Salem at that time. And I want to thank you for coming out today and sharing those pieces of history with us. That was really special. Thank you. And his son is here as well. So grandson and great-grandson of our former mayor are joining us on this special day. Before we have a prelude to our moment of silence, I want to make sure that we just recall a little bit of what Jim was saying in factual order, as he did as well. So 100 years ago, at this time, several barrels of chemicals being stored improperly